Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? Alleluia. In like manner as we have seen him going up into heaven, so shall he come again. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. O clap your hands together, all ye people. O sing unto God with the voice of melody. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? Alleluia. In like manner as we have seen him going up into heaven, so shall he come again. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Hear our Lord Jesus Christ said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and all thy mind. This is the first great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, whom the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that like as we do believe thy only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who ascended into the heavens, so may we also in heart and mind thither ascend, and with him continually dwell, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The first lesson is written in the beginning of the book of the Acts of the Apostles. The former treatise have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and to teach until the day in which he was taken up. After that, he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, having seen of them 40 days, and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said he, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons, which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and the cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by him in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. Hear ye the lesson. Alleluia, alleluia. God is gone up with a merry noise, and the Lord with the sound of the trumpet, alleluia. The Lord is among those in the holy places of Sinai. He has gone up on high. He hath led captivity captive. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Continue. continuation of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high." And he led them out as far as Bethany, and he lifted up his hands and blessed them. And it came to pass, while he blessed them, he was parted from them and carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him, and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and were continually in the temple, praising and blessing God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. One
of those fun traditions on Ascension Day after reading the Gospel is to put out the Paschal candle, and then the Paschal candle being put out, it can be lit at the Easter Mitzvah service, and then it is not lit again until baptisms or funerals. We light it as a remembrance of what we blessed, as, and in recognition of the resurrections, that connection both of baptism and life, right? Remember these religious services we blessed upon. There's a lot of churches had baptisms that day. It's a day where people who have been preparing for the catechism become Christians. But also that death itself is the gateway to eternal life. So we will use the Paschal candle from now through next Easter, until the next Easter Vigil, we'll use this particular candle for all of our funerals and for our baptisms. Maybe we have a few funerals and lots of baptisms. That's our prayer, of course. But today we are celebrating the Feast of the Ascension. It's the 40th day of Easter, and it is the end of Eastertide. The modern lectionary has extended it 10 more days and made it a 50-day season. But in doing so, it lost Ascension time, the season of these 10 days. And it is a time when the church, having watched Jesus ascend into heaven, now prepares for the gift of the Holy Ghost that is to come on Whitsunday or Pentecost Sunday. We, of course, here at St. John's, will be spending the next 9 days praying our novena to God the Holy Ghost. And I have to say, my heart leapt with joy. We made 150 copies of these and put them in the various parish bulletins for the services last week. And we only got 40 of them back. So I'm hoping that there's 110 of them floating around in the hands of our parishioners who will turn to them starting tomorrow morning and will pray the various gifts of God the Holy Spirit. But I will also be emailing them every day, and I will also be referring people to our blog, which is called St. John's HG Novena.blogspot.com, which also has all the prayers, right? To make it as easy as possible for people to join in. But the Feast of the Ascension itself is one which really didn't mean much to me, maybe because it's on a Thursday night, and as you can tell from our massive attendance in the parking lot, it's full. I don't know why not everybody's in here. Okay, I know why. It's Wayne State's graduation. But it's a feast that kind of comes and goes. We think about the resurrection, we celebrate Easter, we celebrate Pentecost, because that's on a Sunday. But at being a Thursday night, the Feast of the Ascension kind of gets lost in all the shuffle. And yet, every time we recite the Creed, we proclaim that Jesus Christ ascended into heaven. So it is one of the core doctrines of the church. And it's obvious that it's something we need to understand because Jesus is not physically here. He's not physically here like he was during his earthly ministry before the cross. He's not physically here like he appeared to the apostles and the disciples from the resurrection until his ascension. But he has ascended or gone up and out into heaven. And for me, what has been most helpful was reading C.S. Lewis's Mere Christianity, where he talks about this, not in the sense of the feast day, but talks about how it is that God can be in all places and at all times. And the explanation for that, of course, is the Feast of the Ascension. While Jesus was present on earth as a human being in every way but sin, he could be in one place at one time. Now, I'm assuming he actually could have been in multiple places if he wanted to, because he's God, right? But allowing himself to be mostly bound by the laws of nature, he was in one place at one time. He walked on water against the laws of nature. But for the most part, laws of nature, okay? One place at one time. And I know as parents, we would have loved at all points to have the gift of bilocation, right? I would have liked to be at the gymnastics meet and at my son's drawing regatta at the same time, right? But not generally a gift that's given, unless you're Padre Pio. Apparently he had that. But Jesus, having gone outside of our time and space,
Having ascended into heaven, he both returns to the Godhead, right? He now is reunited in the Holy Trinity as he was before he came down as a child and took flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary. So he's gone back into the Godhead. He has secondly taken our human flesh with him into the Godhead, right? He intercedes for us. He knows what it's like to be a human being. But also, he is now present, able to be present in all places and at all times, all at once. And that's kind of mind-blowing. Right? Jesus can be in our future, and in our present, and in our past, because he is not confined to our time and space. Right? This is the issue of we're not predestined. It's not predestination, but because he's outside of our time and space, Jesus knows our end as well as knowing our beginning. And I find that really amazing, and I even find it comforting. So we know he's here today at St. John's. He's at Assumption Grotto today. He's at St. Mary's in Greektown. He's at St. Peter's in Corktown. He's at St. Thomas Fifth Avenue in New York City. We could be listening to the webcast right now if we wanted to be. I'm glad we're here instead. All of these places, Jesus is present. And the Ascension is the gateway for that action to happen. So we give thanks to Almighty God for the gift of the resurrection and for the gift of the Ascension. And we pray that God will strengthen us as we prepare for the gift of the coming of the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. God has gone up to the Mary Mount, and the Lord has sat on the trumpet. Alleluia. Blessed art thou, O Lord God of all creation, by him as it was spread to God, from the earth and works from the hands. It become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Bless the Lord this morning. Blessed art thou, O Lord God of all. Of thy goodness, we have this wine to offer, through the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Let us pray for the whole city of Christ Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we only beseech thee most merciful to accept our alms and oblations and receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty. Beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth by holy word, and living unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and the primates of our Anglican community, for well, the Bishop of our diocese, for Keith, my Bishop of Tech, the clergy of this parish, that they may both by their life and doctrine support thy true and lively word, and rightly and freely administer thy holy sacraments. To all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, especially to this congregation here present, with meek heart and due reverence, they may here receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness. or any other adversity.
Praying for our shut-ins.
For Harriet, who's been released from the hospital for her continued recovery.
For Nadine in the hospital.
For Jay, who's recovering from leg surgery.
Joanne, her health issues.
We also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially Robert. Seek thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace to follow the examples of St. Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all the saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Ye who truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to live in life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, the above and deal with.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time discreetly have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these, our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, sake, forgive us all that's past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in this life, for the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath brought us forgiveness of sins to all those who with heart and repentance and true faith turn unto thee, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear comfortable words our Savior Christ said to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Here also, St. Paul said, this is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Here also, St. John said, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, through thy most dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who after his most glorious resurrection manifestly appeared to all his apostles, and in their sight ascended up into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, thither we might also ascend and reign with him in glory. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, thy tender mercy, didst give thy only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. Made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And in his holy gospel command us to continue the perpetual memory of his precious death and sacrifice until his coming. For the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it gave to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Likewise, after supper,
he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the new testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink in remembrance of me."
Wherefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dear beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection, glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by his name. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, and we receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, from the institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. We are since thy Father, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits of death of thy Son Jesus Christ, through faith in his word, we in all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all the benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching, we and all of us, who shall be partakers of this Holy Communion, may worthy receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and be in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer to thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty of service, not weighing on merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ will tell us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercy. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. Thou art a sitting Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed with his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. O Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that takes away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come to my door, but speak the word only, and my soul shall.
Let us pray.
Grant, we beseech thee, almighty merciful God, that what we have received in visible mysteries may work to in us its invisible effect. Almighty God, whose blessed Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, ascended far above all heavens, that he might fill all things, mercifully give us faith to perceive that, according to his promise, he abideth with his church on earth, even unto the end of the world. The same Jesus Christ, our Lord.